Skool Crossfire is brought to you by
Light it up.
And
everybody's smiling. Skin God is for everyone.
But if in a place like Uganda, even if the president decides to announce for the next term, well, he is allowed.
This is the High School Crossfire. Welcome back.
I'm Sonia Laisha Bruno from Bishop Senior, the negative side. The first speaker talked about the inspection of roads, demanding only inspecting of vehicles, but on the requirements in the newspapers of Red Paper 20th, 2017, they need, the requirements are a dialogue of the car and the ID of a person presenting the car, which is one of the requirements, and an ID includes even the driving permit. Thank you.
To begin with, I'm going to begin with the negators. To me, the third negator played his role because he's the very, very person that brought back all the points that were clashed by this side back onto script. And he went ahead and clashed your points. He gave you a multiple choice of more than three POIs, and he could confidently respond, which the two negators did not. Secondly, eye contact. You kept on looking in the side. You are not actually debating for them. They are your competitors. You are debating on behalf of the house. Okay? Now, the affirmatives. I would like to applaud the second. Yes, affirmer. But you're too hot, eh? Breathe. But however, in your language, the first affirmer, do not say relax. That is cheap. Say granted or not granted. Simple. That's where I differed. So in my content, it is because of the third negator that I all gave you 25-25 because he clashed and brought back their points. 25-25. In style, that is where I differed. Their style was chronological. It was on point. At any material time, they had eye contact, they had gestures, use of gestures, they had the flexibility in words. They got 30, you got 25. In strategy, even if maybe the first negator left a little bit out of time, but however, I all gave you 15 in strategy. Having a total of London College, 70, and a total of Bishop MUKONO, 65.
The first speaker from the affirmative, you didn't give us any source where you derived your information from. And the first speaker from the negative gave source and clearly expatiated more on what motor vehicle inspection meant. Now, the only problem came when you asked them a question that was irrelevant about whoever was the leader of this project. Your problem was answering something that you don't know, okay? Matter of fact, if you had asked how relevant it was to your information, you would have brought up a good case. But going ahead to answer wrongly makes you to be punished because that's a lie. But the third speaker came late and he tried to give a greater version of what the debate meant, because these people were specifically talking about accidents, and yet the thing was about inspection of motor vehicles. Now, that's why I went ahead to say content London College has 20, because you clearly lied about your source, as I gave them 30 because they had the source. The style is where I differed. I gave you 30 because your style was okay to me. Though the gentleman, the second gentleman, the affirmative, please make sure you heard. Being first is not bad. Being first in talking is not bad, okay? But make sure you heard that you're not rapping. Now, I gave you 30 and I gave them 20 because their style was poor. One, you asking for points of information as a nuisance, not following the bell, and you're asking for points of information at any time you want, as you're also facing sideways. So strategy, I gave you 10 and I gave them 12, making a total of 60 and 62 for the negative. Thank you.
St. Lawrence, London College. Content, you have 29. Style, you have 30. Strategy, you have 10, making it 69. Bishops, MUKONO. Content, you have 28. Style, you have 29. Strategy, you have 9, making it 67. St. Lawrence London College wins this debate.
It's the High School Crossfire, yet again, another set of winners. Now, the last time we saw these guys on the screen, they hadn't done quite so well, but this time you can see the huge beaming smiles on their faces. You even have a wound on your mouth. Were you fighting to get in there and make sure you're the winner or what?
Sickness.
Okay, me, I'm going to pretend like he beefed one of his... That's how I'm going to take it. And how do you feel about today's debate? What do you think made you guys win this time around?
Well, definitely the fact that we lost the first debate, and we knew this was the only chance that we had to actually come back on board. And so we gave it our all, but something... actually, the first time we hadn't really been on the right track. So after realizing it and... we really did our best. We worked so hard this time around. We put a lot of effort. I mean, it was a do or die situation. When we were up there, we knew it was either a win or a win. So we gave it our best.
Okay, I'm loving his confidence. I'm loving his happiness. It's infectious. So guys, very good job and keep it up. I don't want you to attend next time you lose and then you... I want you to like keep up that trajectory. Okay, thank you. Have a good evening. How are you guys? I see you're smiling, though you didn't do quite so well. What do you think let you down?
Actually, it was my first time to attend such a debate, so I think I did well. Yeah, I did well, according to, because I've never attended such a debate, so we are not badly off.
Okay.
Yeah, I believe we can do better next time, more better than what you have done now, because you have got the experience.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I'm really glad to hear that, you know, you're hoping to do better. What tips are you planning to implement to make sure that, you know, it happens and you win next time?
Definitely. We are, first of all, I've been excited that we have versed the host, and at least the distance of their defeat is not far away from ours, just 5 points, and which I think is a good lesson to us. And I think the next time we are going to perfect for the experience we have had around. So the next time we shall be the best team to go. Yeah, we are ready to go.
I'm expecting big things from you guys. Very big things. At least that you guys, where's your Vaseline and Bizigo from Skin Guard? People might think you didn't take anything away from this.
It's
people. Anyway, it's the High School Crossfire, proudly brought to you by Skin Guard and Pepsi. Thank you for watching.
But if in a place like Uganda, even if the president decides to announce for the next term, well, he is allowed.
POI.
He failed actually to
point of care. Information.
Not taken.
Was brought to you by
Light It Up. Light It Up. Light It Up. Light It Up.
And